So here we have the Jewellery Maker gem setting toolkit. You'll see within this we have several sets of pliers, a pusher, a stone grabber, tweezers, and also a needle file here as well. I'm just going to run you through very quickly how to set an amethyst into a ring. This ring mount does come within the set, and you'll see I've already set it up to hold the ring that I'm going to be setting my gemstone into. Now, these rings are available on our website. They come with the notches already pre-made into the claws. And to set it within this little tool here, all you need to do is stick in the little, it looks like a bit of wedge of cheese, stick that in, make sure it's tight and secure, and you're ready to go. I've already pre-selected an amethyst, which comes in our little gem collector boxes. These are also available under gem setting on the website. Just open that up, they're nice and secure as you can see. And there's my stone. So with our stone grabber, you can pick it up with the tool, and that does make it quite easily if you don't want your fingers and thumbs right in the way. But I often find it easier and I get much more of a feel for the stone by using my fingers. Literally place a stone into the setting, and you see this one sits in quite nicely. If you do find the stone isn't quite flush, you can use your pusher and you can just ease out these claws gently until the stone sits nicely within the setting. Once you've got it to a point where it sits in an area you want it, it's nice and straight, you can adjust it all the time, we can begin stone setting. To do this, you want to place one thumb over the center of the stone. This stage, don't worry too much about its positioning because you can adjust it later. And we just simply begin by using our pusher to ease over the claws, okay? The easiest way to do this, instead of trying to do all the claws in order, is to do opposite claws. So we're going to turn that round, thumb over the center stone and ease the pusher over. You don't want to go mad, you can adjust these all the time, adding a little bit more pressure each time, but you just want to keep going round, adjusting the stone. You can use your index finger if it's easier, push her in, just ease those claws over. And you see I'm just literally pushing that gently. I'm not putting too much pressure on it. These claws, as I've previously said, are already pre-notched, so they are very easy to bend and position into place. Again, and you're just doing them all, as I said, on the diagonal. And once you get into a rhythm, it is quite easy to get into a flow, just adjusting that stone round and easing those claws on the diagonal into place. And then go back round the claws that you started with, just easing them over. You see I'm moving my wrist up and over. I'm not putting any pressure onto the stone itself, if you don't want to slip and damage it. You just go around, ease them all over, and ensuring they're flat. And there you have a set gemstone.